Greetings. There are so many consequences of the lesson of the lifeboat. The fundamental psychological purpose of this child abuse was and is to convince children that not all people have the same value. It can be rather traumatic, and it is intentionally destructive to the moral fabric of the children. Let's take a moment to examine the real consequences of the lifeboat conditioning forced by liberals on generations of Americans. Not all people have the same value. What value does a black woman on welfare bring to liberal society?
Oh, no, you didn't. You did not. Just go there.
Yeah. Somebody needs to go there. Let me be clear. Absolutely clear. This is not what I believe or Christianity teaches. What does the liberal lifeboat conditioning teach about the value a black woman on welfare brings to society? Sadly, the conditioning of the liberal lifeboat drill would teach they are worth nothing because they are a mouth and make more mouths to feed. This is not what Christians could possibly believe if they follow the gospel. Romans 1:16, "For I am not ashamed of this good news about Christ. It is the power of God at work, saving everyone who believes, the Jew first and also the Gentile, or the Jew and the not Jew." So that's everybody. The gospel ascribes value to every human being, every man, woman, and child. The real conflict is that Christianity condemns behaviors. The behavior of having babies without getting married is a bad behavior. The Bible teaches against sex outside marriage. The Bible does not speak against any color when it says so. What other ideas would the liberal lifeboat drill condition into the minds of children? The lifeboat can only hold so many people. Is this the only such place liberals are attempting to condition us to think this? No, consider the Georgia Guidestones. It is a granite structure erected in Georgia, remarkably. It looks like this, kind of like Stonehenge. The Georgia Guidestones have rules written on the six sides of the granite blocks in six languages. Rule number one, maintain human population under 500 million in perpetual balance with nature. Or the lifeboat can only hold so many. Take a moment. Do the math. There are 6.8 billion people alive on Earth. According to the Guidestoners, population must be reduced to only 500 million. The lifeboat will not hold two-thirds, as in the school example, 10 out of 15. Lifeboat Earth can only hold 1 out of every 14 people. 13 out of 14 people must not be allowed to live and reproduce. This is the worldview of the Guidestoners. Sadly, I think they are actually willing to cause war to decimate the population of Earth. Think of North Korea allowing millions of its citizens to starve to death. Not just allowing, but actually starving them to death through intentional deprivation of food. In the last century, communism killed roughly 250 million people around the world. That same worldview planted the liberalism we see infecting America and the civilized world today. There is a reason communists kill Christians and priests. The Judeo-Christian worldview is a direct contradiction and threat to their lifeboat conditioning. But communists are only obeying the evil which motivates them, the same evil that has driven men throughout time. Ephesians 6:12, "For we do not wrestle against flesh and blood, but against the rulers, against the authorities, against the cosmic powers over this present darkness, against the spiritual forces of evil in the heavenly places." This is the difficult conundrum of the gospel, which Christians must daily walk. But to those of you who will listen, I say, love your enemies. Do good to those who hate you. Bless those who curse you. Pray for those who mistreat you. It is hard to describe how impossible this is under our own human imperfections. And yet this is the heart of the gospel. Love. John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that everyone who believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life. Time is short. Our mission is love. Our Christian responsibility is to be able to give an answer why we believe. Part of that understanding is to recognize the ideas and worldviews that attack the gospel. The liberal lifeboat drill is one such flawed lesson and attack against the gospel's worldview that values every man, woman, and child. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to his Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.